Hi friends, welcome. I welcome you to my YouTube channel. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Today in machine design I am going to take up design of shafts. Now, a shaft is defined as a rotating machine element which transmits power, mechanical power or motion. Now, generally shafts are made of MS and they are generally circular in section. They may be either solid or hollow. A hollow shaft is better than a solid shaft due to various reasons. Now, yes, the shafts are manufactured in standard sizes. We don't get any size we want, we do not get. They are manufactured in standard sizes. Those standard sizes will be given to you in the design data handbook. Generally they give the standard sizes or standard diameters of the shaft. Let us say the standard sizes are something like this, 70, 80, something like that is there. There may be any number of sizes after that. For example, I have taken, let us say it is like this. And we calculate the dia of the shaft, the diameter of the shaft, and we get the answer as 72.358624, something like that. In our calculator, we get some number like this, so many millimeter. Now, when we get the answer like this, what we have to do is, we have to go to the standard table giving the standard sizes of the shaft, and now you see the value that I am getting here is between these two. It is somewhere between these two. Now what I do is adopt the dia of the shaft as 80 mm. Always we should adopt the next available standard size after this. We should not take it as 70 mm, though in mathematics they say if this is less than 5 you can take it as 70. That rule should not be followed. Always in design you must be positive, you must be always on the higher side, you must adopt it on the higher side. The dimension should be always greater. If it is greater, it doesn't matter. If a few mm greater, it doesn't matter, but it should not be even a fraction of a mm less than that, because if it is lesser in size, there is a likelihood, there is a chance that it may break. So it should always be rounded up on the positive side, right? Then the length of the shaft is limited to 6 meters. This is the maximum length, standard length of a shaft is 6 meters. If we want a shaft longer than this, we have to use couplings to join them and make it into one shaft. Now, as we have studied in strength of materials in third sem, shafts are subjected to torsional stresses, right? So they are designed by using the torsion equation. Now, shafts, from design point of view, shafts are classified into two types. Shafts are classified broadly into two types. One is called the machine shafts, and the other is called line shaft. Now, generally these shafts are shorter in length. An integral part of a machine, like maybe the crankshaft, the shaft of an electric motor, the shaft of a mill. They are short shafts and they do not carry many loads on them. Now, such shafts are considered to be subjected to only torsion, though there will be some amount of bending will be there, because a shaft will be supported in bearings and you are putting loads. So there will be some bending, but that bending is very small here. In the case of bending, stresses will be small and hence they may be neglected. But in the case of a transmission shafts, they are longer in length and they are having many loads acting on different places on the along their axis, and hence they are subjected to larger bending moment, and we cannot neglect the bending moment. So they are subjected to, they are considered to be subjected to both torsion, twisting, as well as bending. Both bending and torsion will be there here. Here they are considered to be subjected to only torsional stresses or twisting stresses. So the design of these shafts is simpler compared to the design of transmission shafts. Now, first we will take up the design of design of machine shafts. Now, because they are design of machine shafts, because they are considered to be subjected to only twisting, only torsion, they can be designed by using the general torsion equation which we have studied in strength of materials. You remember, this general torsion equation is T by J is equal to tau by R, shear stress divided by R, is equal to G theta or C theta divided by L. Now, here you know all these things. T is the maximum torque on the shaft. In Newton mm, J is polar moment of inertia. This is permissible torsional shear stress. This is the distance between the neutral axis and the this is actually the radius, distance between the outermost fiber to the neutral axis in mm. This d by 2, this is modulus of rigidity, this is angle of twist, this is length of the shaft. Now, if a shaft is designed by using T by J is equal to tau by R, then it is said to be designed on the basis of strength. On the basis of strength. If it is designed by using T by J is equal to G theta by L, then it is, that is these two, if you use these two and then find the diameter, it is said to be designed on the basis of rigidity. So there are two designs here, one on the basis of strength and the other one on the basis of rigidity. Now, if T is given, twisting moment or torque is given, and tau is given, these are not given, then it means we have to design it only on the basis of strength only. If they have given T, they have given tau, they have given G, theta and L, all are given, this is also given, this is also given, then you have to design it on both strength basis and rigidity basis. You get two values of D, one from here, one from here. In that case, you will have to adopt the higher of the two values, right? Whichever is greater, that should be taken as the design of the dia of the shaft. Now, if it is hollow shaft also, it is the same thing. You have to find out both the outer and inner diameter. They will give you the ratio of inner to outer diameters. Now, generally in the design data handbook, what they do is, they give direct formula. That is, if it is on the basis of strength, we use T or T max is equal to pi d cube by 16 into tau. This formula we get from this only, but it is direct. If you know these two, you can get the value of d. D can be got. So d will be equal to 16 T max divided by pi into tau, if it is whole to the power of 1 by 3, so many millimeter, if it is solid shaft, if you are designing it on the basis of strength. If it is a hollow shaft, then it will be DO 16 T max divided by pi into tau into 1 minus k to the power of 4 whole to the power of 1 by 3. This will give you the outer dia of the shaft. K is di by do, ratio of inner to outer diameter. Tau is this thing. This is for solid shaft. This is for hollow shaft. This is for hollow shaft. And if you are designing it on the basis of strength, that is T by J equals tau by R. Then if you are designing on the basis of rigidity, then they use this formula, theta is equal to 584 T max into L divided by GD to the power of 4. From here, you can get D. This is called angle of twist. If it will be generally given in degrees, so it has been, you can directly use it, use theta in degrees and use this formula. If it is hollow shaft, it will be 584 T max into L divided by G into DO to the power of 4 into 1 minus K to the power of 4, so many degrees. From here you have to get D and DO. This is for solid shaft if you are designing it on the basis of rigidity. This is for hollow shaft if you are designing it on the basis of rigidity. These two formulae for this thing. For on strength basis, those two formulae on rigidity basis. So this is how we have to do it. We'll take up a few problems on this first. I'm selecting a few problems on machine shaft. So problem number 2 from the question bank. It says select the diameter of the shaft for a mild steel shaft rotating at 240 rpm and transmitting a power of 1 megawatt. The maximum torque transmitted exceeds the mean torque by 20%. Maximum torque is 1.2 times mean torque. The allowable shear stress tau is 60 megapascal or 60 newton per mm square. Find the dia of the shaft. Now they have not given, these are not given, theta is not given, G is not given, and L, length of the shaft, is also not given. That means we need not design it on the basis of rigidity. You have to understand that we are not going to use the rigidity formula here. Only tau is given. So we are going to design it only on the basis of strength. If they have given these things, then we have to design it on both the basis. Now we are not going to design it on this basis. We are going to design it only on the basis of strength only. Now the formula when we are designing on strength basis is T max is equal to pi d cube by 16 into tau, or directly if you are using d is equal to 16 T max divided by 16 T max divided by pi into tau whole to the power of 1 by 3 or under cube root. So this is the formula. This and this are one and the same. Right. This I am getting from this T by J equals tau by R by substituting J is pi d to the power of 4 by 32, that is polar moment of inertia, and R is d by 2. If you substitute that, you will get this. From this, you can get this. Anyway, this is a direct formula. So what I want is d. To get d, I should know this and this. This is already given. The permissible shear stress is of the material of the shaft is given as 60 megapascal. So that is there. What I don't know now is this. Unless I get that is the maximum torque to be transmitted by the shaft. Unless I get that, I will not get the die of the shaft. Now to get this, they have given this data. This data is given. So from this, what you have to do is, you have to first find out the mean torque. For this power and this speed, what is the mean torque? Now the power is given in megawatt. I will convert it into kilowatts. So this will be equal to 1000 kilowatt. 1000 kilowatt is called as 1 megawatt. Now T will be equal to 9.55 P divided by N into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm. For this power and this speed, this formula will give me the torque or the twisting moment. This is called as the mean or the average torque which I get. Again, this formula I get from P is equal to 2 pi n t by 60 kilowatts. From this formula, T will be equal to 60 P divided by 2 pi n. That 60 by 2 pi n will be approximately 9.55. To convert it from kilo Newton meter to Newton millimeter, you use this. We multiply it by 10 to the power of 6. So this is called as the mean torque. So it is 9.55 into P is 1000 divided by 240 into 10 to the power of 6. This 10 to the power of 6 keep as it is. 9.55 into 1000 divided by 240 gives me 39.78 into 10 to the power of 6. Directly I am getting it in Newton millimeter. Now this is average torque or the mean torque. Now what he wants is, he says increase this by 20%, because sometimes what happens accidentally, this torque may increase slightly. So to give a margin for that, he says 20%. 20% of this should be added, 20% of this should be added to this, and then we should design it for that. So it will be T plus 0.2T, that will be maximum torque. Maximum torque will be this T plus 20% of that T, or maximum torque will be equal to T max is equal to 1.20, if it is 20% more, 1.20 into this. So here 1.20 into 39.8 into 10 to the power of 6, keep that 10 to the power of 6 as it is, into 1.2 if you do, it will be 47.75 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm. This is the maximum torque. Now we have the maximum torque, we have tau. If we substitute there, we get the dia of the shaft. This is the simplest problem. It is 16 into 47.75 divided by pi into 60 under cube root. So, 47.75 into 10 to the power of 6, I left that, whole to the power of 1 by 3 r under cube root into 16 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi divided by 60. That will give me some value. Cube root answer equals, I am getting 159.44 mm. This is the dia of the shaft required to for the purpose, for the given purpose. Now what I do, I go to the standard table. So here size of shaft standard table is given 12, 15, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12. These diameters are given. I am getting between 150 and 160 mm. 150, it is more than 150, but less than 160. Here, after 150, the next size available is 160 mm. So I will adopt D is equal to dia of the shaft. I have to use a dia of 160 mm to meet the given conditions. All right. So this is what you, this is how you get it. Next, we'll take up problem number 3 from the question bank. Select the diameter of a solid steel shaft to transmit 20 kilowatt 200 rpm. The ultimate shear stress, tau ultimate, is 360 MPa, 360 MPa. Factor of safety is 8. This is first one. Design a solid shaft. Find the dia of the shaft. Second part. If a hollow shaft is to be used in place of solid shaft, if it is a hollow shaft, find the inside and outside diameter. Find DO and DI, or capital D and small d, whatever it is. If the ratio of inside to outside diameter is 0.5, that is K is 0.5, then find DO and DI. This is second part. This is first part. In first part, they have given this and they are asking us to do it. Now, these two, that is power and speed, are given for us to find the torque or the twisting moment. So I have the same formula, T is equal to 9.55 P divided by N into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm. So 9.55 into P, this is first one, solid shaft, I am designing solid shaft, into 20 divided by 200 into 10 to the power of 6. This works out to 0.955 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm. Right, this is the average torque. This itself is the maximum torque also, because he hasn't said you increase it or do anything, he hasn't said. So this itself will be the design torque or the maximum torque. Next, to get diameter, I want this diameter of the solid shaft. I should know tau. Tau ultimate is given, not the permissible value. So tau now will be equal to tau ultimate divided by factor of safety. Factor of safety for ultimate will be 4 to 8. If they have not given, we have to select it, but since he has given it, we will use the same thing. So this will be 360 divided by 8. That will be 45 MPa, 45 megapascal or 45 Newton per mm square. Now we got both T and tau. So D will be equal to 16 T max. Here T only is T max. Pi into tau whole to the power of 1 by 3 or under cube root. So 16 into 0.955 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi into 45 under cube root. This gives me the diameter of the shaft. So take the calculator, 16 multiplied by 0.955 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi, again divided by 45 equals, I get some value 108083 point something, cube root of answer, cube root answer equals 47.63 I am getting, 47.63 mm. Go to the standard size table, table in the design data handbook, there is 45 mm, then there is 50 mm. After 45, only 50 mm is there. So D will be equal to, adopt D is equal to 50 mm. So the first part is over. To transmit this much power at this speed, if the stress is so much, the dia of the shaft must be equal to 50 mm. We have designed it. Next, he says, if in place of this, if we are using a hollow shaft, what should be its diameters? What should be the inner and the outer diameters? Now the maximum torque hasn't changed. It is 0.955 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton meter, Newton mm only. Tau hasn't changed. It is 45 Newton per mm square or megapascal only. Now K is 0.5. This is extra. What is DO and DI? You have to find out. So the formula for outer dia is 16T divided by pi into tau into 1 minus K to the power of 4. This is extra. Here only pi into tau is there. Here it will be pi into tau multiplied by 1 minus k to the power of 4 whole to the power of 1 by 3. So it will be 16 into 0.955, same torque, into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi into 45. Pi into 45 into 1 minus 0.5. to the power of 4. Now what we will do is this whole to the power of 1 by 3 under cube root. 16 first we will take up this new denominator, 1 minus 0.5 to the power of 4 equals, it works out to 0.9375 into 45 into pi. 1 minus 0.5 to the power of 4, that is 0.9375 into 45 into pi. What I have done is I have multiplied these three. I got some answer, 132.5 something. I'll keep it as it is. Now I'll put the numerator, 16 into 0.955 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by answer will give me 115289. This entire thing I got as 115289.48 something. Cube root of this I want, press inverse cube root of answer. This I am getting 48.6 mm. Again it is coming between 45 and 50. So adopt DO as 50 mm only. 50 mm only. Now, here 50 mm only. Now, DI, inner diameter, will be K into DO, because K is DI by DO. So, DI will be K into DO, that is 0.5 into 50. So, this works out to 25 mm. So, outer dia is 50, inner dia is 25. See, advantage here is, if you are using a solid shaft, it is 50 mm dia. If you are using a hollow shaft, the outer dia is 50, inner diameter is 25. Now, because of the there is lesser material here used, and the weight is lesser, but the strength is the same, almost the same. Same strength it will have. It will be more, it will have more reliability, because stress distribution will be better here. So, this is a better shaft than this.